Yeah, this is Jimmy. This is a class 10 car. Got her in Mexico. Yeah, she's with the team for a couple years. We picked her up. She's changed her life. Suspension, you can pretty much run over everything at like 100 miles an hour. Like, a lot of whoops out here, and so the rear engine, you get weight back there, so then you can kind of just float over the whoop. You want the front to stay up. So the idea behind it is we got weight back here, stay on the gas, and just put it over the whoop. To get to where it is now, where we can be competitive. It's gonna be that all day. The course, it starts out pretty chewed up, so like little nervous to not do any crazy damage, but yeah, we're here, we've been camping out, been here for 2 days now. It just keeps getting dustier, more cars roll up.
I started out racing as a young buck in the NorCal karting scene, banging gears and slinging rubber. I got an opportunity to race a formula car out of go-karts, and that's where it all started. Ended up winning a national championship, got selected as a Mazda finalist, and then I found desert racing.
TJ Fisher here. First race of the season. We're here at Hammertown. It's King of the Hammers, February 3rd. Tim, the cameraman, shows up. All mayhem. I didn't even tell him where to go. There's no service out here. If we didn't find him, he probably would have camped out in the Jeep, just on the side of the road. So it's been some chaos, but we're loving it. Trying to get some order in it. See how this goes. Cheers.
Is that them? How'd she go?
Huh?
How'd she go?
She went great.
Now beginning for TJ and Byron in this race. We're out here with King of the Hammers. Nice and dusty. The Dust Bowl is going on this weekend. We're gonna go out there tomorrow. I think I'm planning on staying in the car the whole race, the whole 200 miles. And TJ's doing the first half. Ron's doing the second half. Stoked to be out here. Stoked to be out of work. Rad, not in the office. Super sick. And we're loving it. Having fires, drinking beer. We're doing it right.
So we just passed technical inspections. We had a little seatbelt mandate we had to get around. But we passed. So we're good to go race. Qualifying tomorrow. I'm gonna do a test of the qualifying course now. We're all a little hungry and fried, honestly.
But the hard part with even developing strategy so far is that you've never been here. There's a lot of unknown. We'll learn more at the driver's meeting of like really what's at stake at this qualifying. Is it just for position or is it gonna like attach to our time? I don't know that.
The way I thought about this is like prologue in a book doesn't count as the pages you.
That's a great point.
Right? Like that's the name of qualifying is prologue.
Okay, fair enough. Well, I think like, you know, you want to be aggressive. There's not a lot to hurt you in that prologue section. I mean, there's a few spots that you could miss or whatever, but you're starting first off the line out of the 10 cars. The 17th guy has to go through 16 cars of dust. You may have some Jeeps in front of you and some slow truckers in front of you that you have to contend with. If you've caught them already, you're way faster than them.
That's right.
And there's several lines everywhere where it, you know, where it opens up. Exactly. They're here to hammer it. That's what we're here to do also.
Yeah, we're here to hammer it. All right, let's get hammered.
That's interesting, seeing that guy like implode on stage.
Wasn't that?
Yeah.
He got pulled off pretty quick.
He fucking like...
Well, he just went after everybody.
Yeah.
He got a little emotional.
But he didn't even have a rule yet. It's just, I don't know what the penalty will be. I'm not sure yet.
Yeah, but you're over. It's done.
But I believe that class 10, and it's always been probably one of the most, which is our B2 class, has been one of the most competitive classes, bar none.
40 miles, I didn't. And it kind of sets our starting spot for tomorrow. We are leading the class 10s off. The sun's out today. We stopped at the AMPM or something on the way. Grabbed the hat. It's got a hole in top. $6, so decided it was the score of the day. In the car ready to go for the prologue. Got the skirt in, tires torqued. And yeah.
Sitting here in the I guess this is the pre-grid, the staging is where we're at. It's just like a dust bowl. It's like a cluster. Nobody knows what's going on, but we're just rolling with it. Would you say GTD? Get things done? We're rolling off first off the line. So like, you know, for me, I don't have a ton of experience. I've never done this race. So it's good. It's good because I'm not going to be in all the other 10 cars dust. Dust is a huge factor here. It looks like there's no wind, so you know, everything's just kind of sitting.
Dust, like,
so all these cars are gonna have a trail of dust. I just gotta like feel my way through it. Just road racing. This is like, it's another level. Like, I gotta figure it out quick. So I'm a little nervous, but you know, it's always get that before a race. You know, just gotta feel it out. So we'll see. Let's go. And like everybody's just like waiting there by the victory.
Yeah.
I felt calm. That was like, I felt calmer than usual. The thing is like, yeah, this left shock is leaking. You can see it, like, you see all this fluid around here, it's dark and oily. So like this shock that's supposed to be doing all of the work out in Hammertown, it's like leaking oil. So, you know, this is probably working out half as well as it should be. So that was definitely affecting it. And the rough whoops, like, car was just getting tossed. Me and Drew were just like all over the place coming into the Hammertown. It was crazy. And once, at one point I thought we were gonna roll. Like, it went over sideways and it was like, ah! It landed and then bucked the other way. And it was just like, okay, oh my God, stay.
built it from scratch.
I've had it quite a bit apart, but not all the way.
Basically, had
it needs
down
lots of bolts.
Had it down to the frame.
He's welded it back together.
Pulled the tranny, put a new motor in it, rebuilt the CVs.
Glenn Howard. I mean, literally bent it in half. So that was way back in the day when we short course 1600. I was co-driving with him. Dude, we took the hump in the middle of the Baja Bug and it went over itself. He sailed this thing off a jump and I was just like, oh no, here we go. We hit, I saw stars. I was young back then too. I mean, he was a kid, he was a baby.
Sent it.
Oh dude, sent it. And that was, this is back when we didn't have radios. They could hear me screaming at him from the co-driver's seat in the stands. Girl, we bent cars in half.
Jesus.
Oh no, I've known Byron for a long, long time.
Like, I saw all the ways and everybody's methods of quickness to the throttle, quickness to the brakes, you know, delay on throttle. Like, I watched them all. No, there was guys that were way worse, but then there was guys that were popping, just like just on it instead of.
So right, there's a driver change. Las Vegas to Reno race that we did.
Yeah.
Seatbelts got stuck and we lost.
We lost 5 to 6 minutes in the pits, which ultimately cost us 2 places on the ground. And in a race like that, it's extremely costly.
Really fun experience. You know, 40 miles of that is pretty cool.
Does it prepare you for tomorrow?
I think so. I think it, yeah, you got a feeling for the course. It's the same flow of, like, there's no gotchas in the course. It's just kind of like you go into sections, so you kind of know what you can get out of it. There's a few, like, where it gets rough and then it goes up and down, and then, you know, there's some hairpins. But for the most part, it's like fast, flowy.
You mentioned you were in sixth gear a lot.
Yeah.
What was it like getting a sixth gear?
Yeah.
Fast. Fast, flowy, a little whoopy, but like the car hooks up and, you know, you're in six before you know it.
What about the area that we struggled to find that line?
We found it. We did find the line.
Okay. So Drew knows where it is.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, it's just staying left enough and then one of the lanes just dips down into the
one of them.
One of them.
You had Richardson, you had all these guys, you had John Marking, you know, so many different great drivers came from Class 10.
Well, it's moved to my ass and lower hamstrings. So last night I could not fucking roll over. And I thought for a minute there that, like, it was gonna be a no-go. But it would take a lot for me to not go. Yes. They're stopped at race mile 85.
Oh no.
So we don't know what's going on yet.
That's easy for your guy. Okay. He said it broke the driveline, so it's transmission or something. I think it's race mile 30. He says they're pretty much done. Okay. Race mile 31. 1058, right?
Yep.
Yep, he called one of our guys. Or meet you guys out there, so I just let you know.
Thank
where
you.
Where again?
31.
Yeah.
On the tracker, he's at 85, though.
I don't know. There's a lot of information coming in.
No.
You know that.
Okay.
He's not moving.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Appreciate it.
Who was your guys?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
So we're getting some information that possibly they're broken with the transmission.
Yeah, drop it up.
I don't know yet. I don't know. I think that somebody goes and gets them.
as a bird flies.
Sucks that we lost
over the
TV, but that was the best time I think I've ever had in a race bar.
We probably look like we just got shot out of a cannon.
Like a dusty one. Like, I can't even put my hair, fingers through my hair.
I can't either.
It's like, it was dusty out there.
We got hammered.
We got hammered.
We were the nail. We were the nail in the situation. Yeah. There was some chaos. You know, no idea where we were starting. Still don't really actually know.
Like, how did we qualify?
Not great.
Who knows? Like, we don't even know.
We don't even know. One of the times. But I already want to come back. I already have a plan. We're going to run that prologue course. We know what this car can do. And we just need to be in some clean air running up front. The front runners lost down. But, that was so fun.
So fun. Great battle. I
can find it hard. You know, a tough L for Roosterfish Racing. First race of the season. Never want to open up on a DNF like that. I feel like we didn't really get to prove our pace. The good part of this all, though, is like we raced really, really well. And we were embroiled in battles. We're passing class 10 cars. We're moving up the field. We just got to learn how to qualify. Like, we're already creating a strategy to come back here for Hammers in 2024. You know, we'll swallow this one, take it on the chin. And, you know, we're hoping the next race is either another race out here in beautiful Lucerne Valley, or the Baja 500, which could be really fun. As for what's next, we gotta repair the CV. It's early February, so like Carrera Cup season starts mid-March. It's coming up quick. We just got the car in. We're gonna do a little bit of testing. Sebring's up next. Sebring is a really bumpy track. Nothing like what we got out here. It's actually paper smooth compared to this thing.
Peeps love Coors beer. I don't drink Coors beer.
This is gonna be the best Carrera Cup season yet. There's gonna be at least 45 cars. We got the last allocation on the 992 GT3 Cup car. So that was really rad. Thank you, Porsche, for hooking that up, and Ryan, Jeremy, and all the guys. And Troy as well. You guys did an excellent job helping a new team, small team, start out in the Carrera Cup Series. So we're looking to build on our success from last year. We actually have 4 wins in a row from the Sprint Challenge. Carrera Cup is a completely different ballgame though. It's like really, really competitive. We're a small team. We're not gonna be testing like the big dogs, but we are gonna be testing. So we got 2 Formula One races. We're gonna be racing at Long Beach, and we're gonna be racing with NASCAR. So like, I'm stoked. And I'm excited to bring you guys along, show you guys what's happening. You know, sometimes it's a shit show. A lot of the time there's debauchery, but we get to go racing. And that's what it's all about in the end. Having a good time, good people. Hopefully there's more. Cut. I'm hot. I need a shower.
Racing. You're racing.
I'm going as fast as you can.
Like, I hope you tell them. It's fucking hilarious. and then the battery died.
In what? The Jeep?
In the Jeep. What? And then we were like damsels in distress, so it was awesome. So we were like, can you guys help us? Our car is dead. And like, all these people came around to help us. And then they were like, hey, did you make sure the door's locked or unlocked or whatever? Because maybe the car won't start. So we're like playing with it. And then the guy puts the battery on it. And they're like, okay, turn it on. We go. We had locked the door. We locked the car, shut the door. The keys were inside. And the keys were locked in the car. Yes.
No.
And we had this little gap in the window. And we had to find this girl with skinny arms to come hand in and unlock the car door so that we could turn the car on with it. I mean, it was a whole adventure.
Wow.
It was like a community involvement
situation.
It was pretty good.
Sure, everybody was involved.
Two girls needing help.
Yeah.
This is great.
Perfect situation for the guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, similar community effort.
Yeah, it was
yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly the same.